Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure SyncFusion Angular Datetime Picker using the Angular CLI tool and SyncFusion EJ2 Angular Calendars package. The Angular Datetime Picker is a lightweight and mobile-friendly component that allows users to enter or select date and time values from a pop-up calendar and drop-down time list. I will show you how to configure a few of its basic features, like setting specific date values, formatting, mask support, and restricting date time selection in a specific date range. Let me show you the application creation process. First, I create my application using the Angular CLI command. I use VS Code as the editor and show the output in the Chrome browser. In the command prompt, I install the CLI tool globally using the command npm install global Angular CLI. Then I create a new Angular project using the ng new command and provide the app name, my Angular project. I navigate to the desired location and install the datetime picker package using the command ng add SyncFusion EJ2 Angular Calendars. Now, I open the project in VS Code. To start using the Datetime Picker component, navigate to the App Module page and import the Datetime Picker module from the SyncFusion EJ2 Angular Calendars package and register it in the Imports array of the NG module. After that, I import the Material Theme Styles to the style.css file to apply styles to the Datetime Picker. Next, I need to register the SyncFusion license key. Open the main TypeScript file and import the register license method from the SyncFusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, register the Angular trial license. From the 2022 Volume 1 release, a license key is mandatory in Angular projects to avoid license warning. In the app.component.html file, replace the default code snippets with the Angular Datetime Picker using the EJS Datetime Picker tag. Then assign the styles for this wrapper element. I will run this project using the command ng-serve. As you can see, the output displays the datetime picker, and I can enter or select date and time values from the pop-up calendar and drop-down time list. When the Today button is clicked, it shows the current date. I can also show a short hint in the input element of the datetime picker when no value is selected. I set the placeholder property and assign the value, choose a date and time. See here, the hint is now displayed in the input element. Next, I will show you how to select a specific date and time to be displayed on initial load. Dates can be specified using the value property. Within the app component class, I define a variable, date value of the date type, and assign a value. I then assign this variable to the value property. Check now, the specified date is shown on the datetime picker input and selected on the calendar pop-up. Now, let me show you how to restrict the date and time value selection within a specified range by defining the min and max properties. Within the app component class, I declare a variable minDate of the date type and set a start date value. Similarly, I define another variable, maxDate, and set it as the end date value. Then, I assign these values to the corresponding min and max properties. Check now, I cannot select the dates that are beyond the specified min and max date range. You can select the date and time from June 6, 2022, 9 a.m. to June 10, 2022, 6 p.m. You can also use built-in mask support in Datetime Picker to enter a valid date. To use the mask support, open App Module page, import the Mask Datetime Service module and inject it in the Providers array of NG module. Then in the HTML page, I add the Enable Mask property and set its value to true. As you can see, I can enter the date and time based on the mask pattern. The mask is formed based on the default format of the current culture. Let me show you how to apply a custom format to the date shown in the Datetime Picker. It accepts standard and custom date and time format strings as specified in MSDN. I add the format property and set its value to a custom format DDMMMYYHHMM. See now in the datetime picker, the specified format is applied to the selected date. This shows how easily you can define the features of the Angular datetime picker using its simple built-in APIs. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure the Syncfusion Angular Datetime Picker component using the Angular CLI command and a few of its basic features. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.